Hello, my lovely friends. My name is Ava, and today I have some Christmas romances that are a little bit on the paranormal monster side. These are 8 romances that take place during Christmas time and have that little flair of holiday cheer, but they have either a paranormal aspect, a monster aspect, or an alien aspect to it. I already have a romance video for more contemporary and historical ones. That one has already been out, so be sure to go check that one out if you want not paranormal stuff in your Christmas romances, but I find these books to be so fun to read, especially during the holiday season, because these authors are just so creative. The first one that I would love to mention is Dear Monster Claws by Maeve Black. I absolutely loved this one last year. In this universe, our holiday creatures or holiday figures are monsters, and like we don't really know that they're monsters, but they are. So our heroine here is a Cupid, and the hero in here is actually Santa, and he's like the red dragon creature on the cover. This is a grumpy sunshine romance between the Cupid and Santa. Cupid decides to write a letter to Santa, and all she wants for Christmas is someone to basically love her. And he decides to seek out said Cupid because she just seems so happy all the time in all the letters that she writes, and he is missing that cheer. And so he's just gonna go seek out, figure out who this woman is. And they kind of strike up a deal when they meet up with each other. She will get him back in the Christmas holiday spirit if he gives her some love lessons, if you will. This was such a fun, cute read during the holiday season. This is one of those books that is cute, but hot. Okay. Don't let the cute factor discredit that this book is actually like flaming hot at moments. But I also really love the cute moments as well. Like she does a lot of baking and cooking. There's actually, I think, even a few recipes in the book for like holiday treats. But I definitely think that you need to pick this one up during the holiday Christmas season. The next book in the series is more Valentine's Day based, so you can look forward to picking the sequel up around Valentine's Day if you want to be a seasonal reader. My lovely Ruby Dixon came out with When She's Merry last year, and I gave this one 5 stars. I loved it. This is book number 9 in her Rizdiverse series, which is an alien romance series that she's written, just a collection of novellas that take place on the same planet. If you just want to read this one, go on ahead. There are a few things you need to know beforehand, like setting up the book. You can just DM me on Instagram or something to ask me what they are, because like other than knowing like a few facts, like you should be perfectly fine to read this book as a standalone. Pretty much any of the Rizdiverse books, you could do that. Our heroine in here is a human woman who was abducted from Earth, and she lives on this planet Rizda 3, where a bunch of other human refugees live. And our hero in here is one of the kind of like alien protectors on the planet for human women specifically. And he keeps checking in on the heroine because he knows that he gets on her nerves. She doesn't really like this guy. He also at one point tried to kill her pet. Like there's this rodent that has started like living on her farm, and she kind of adopted it as her pet, but it's kind of like a possum. Like it's super ugly, but it's like whole being is to be with the heroine, like they are best friends. And so he tries to kill her pet at one point, and she gets so mad at him, but he didn't realize that that was her pet. Like he's a rodent. Anyway, our heroine in here figures out that one of the older human women that live on the planet is kind of becoming a shut-in. She's not leaving her home. She's very depressed, and she decides to gift her with some holiday cheer. She doesn't know if it's Christmas time. She doesn't know what it's like on Earth right now, but she decides to celebrate Christmas with her anyway. And she goes and finds a tree, and the hero like takes it upon himself to help her with the decorations and the helping and the cooking and the baking and everything and the presents. And it is so cute. I absolutely adored this one. This book had its serious moments because it does deal with grief and depression and mental health, but it has these moments where you have characters trying to uplift someone else and help them through those times. And so I just really appreciated that. And I think Ruby did an amazing job dealing with serious topics like that. But you also have hilarious moments sprinkled in. Like I think the heroine even like dresses up her rodent at one point to get in like the Christmas spirit. Like it's so funny. A very short one is A Very Krampus Holiday by Katie Robert. This is just a short little, I think like 20 page or even less than that, novella about a heroine getting punished by Krampus for Christmas. If you don't know what Krampus is like the evil version of Santa, I guess. He like has horns and kind of looks like a satyr a little bit to me. I don't know. but you can go look it up if you're curious. Go to Google. I don't know. But if you just want a short, quick monster romance read to maybe cleanse your palate during the holiday season, this one is one you could pick up. Ooh, another like foodie cute one is Chimera for Christmas by Ursa Dax. Sophie in here is our human woman, and she gets a holiday job working at this space station that's kind of like a mall, but it's a space station, like it's huge. And they sell a bunch of holiday goods and holiday treats. And she gets a job at the coffee bar, coffee place during the holiday season because they're very busy during that time and they needed to hire someone else. When she gets there, she ends up meeting her burly, very grumpy coworker who happens to be a chimera. Right when she meets him, she is utterly smitten with him. She thinks he is so attractive and so cute, despite that he's very gruff to her and to everyone else. His name is X, and he's a chimera, and he at first is very annoyed that he has to have another coworker with him, but once he gets to know Sophie, he cannot help but fall in love with this chatterbox of a woman because she is a very big chatterbox. This is another cute but hot alien romance read, okay? This one gets good. I'll just leave it there. Another under 100 page novella is Grave Tidings by Salem Sinclair. Look at this cover, y'all. Look at it. I was like hooked based off the cover. This is another romance. I guess this is a commonality with monster romances during the holidays. Our heroine in here, her name is Noelle, and she is also being punished by Krampus on Christmas Eve. I preferred this one to the other one I talked about. This one has like ropes and other stuff, and man, does he punish her. Okay. But there was nothing else to it besides like them having a moment during Christmas Eve and maybe something happening further on down the line. We'll see. But I thought this was a great little 75 page book. Okay. It was super fun. Next I have Mary or Mortem by K.L. Mann. This is the first book in the Tombstone University like novella series. And I think all the books in the series take place like during a holiday time. This takes place after book one in the series, where that heroine from book one, her roommate and best friend can't find her because of what happened in book one. That one takes place during Halloween, by the way. Anyway, she can't find her roommate. And so she goes to Gretchen, who is kind of like the college like snob. And she's like, Gretchen, I know you know where my friend is. Like, I just know it. So you have to tell me and bring me to her. And Gretchen is like, okay. I'll do it if you agree to be mine for, I think, the entire night of Christmas Eve, and you have to do whatever I say. So this is an FF, like, sapphic romance. What Jamie doesn't know, the heroine, she is human, and Gretchen is a succubus. Jamie doesn't know that, like, paranormal creatures are even, like, a thing, and so she's very shocked when she realizes this about Gretchen, and their, like, hate-to-love animosity relationship turns very lustful very quick during this book. There is trigger warnings in here, by the way, for murder, piercings, and choking. So just be aware of that. I do have to mention Satan by Lila Fay, okay? This is a part of her Monsters Ever After series, and you wouldn't think that Satan is in a Christmas book, but he is, okay? So our heroine in here, she is dyslexic, and for years she's been writing these letters to Santa, or so she assumes. She's been actually writing to Satan. She doesn't realize that she's writing to Satan in her letters. And she doesn't actually like send them to Santa. She just burns them afterward because she just wants to get her feelings out, you know? But she doesn't know that that's how Satan gets his mail, is that you put the letter in a fire and then he'll get the letter. And so for years, she's been writing these letters to Satan, and he's been reading all of them and just been biding his time to get with this woman. And so this is finally about one Christmas, he decides to go and get what he wants. And what he wants is our heroine. This is a short, fun read. Very funny. Lila Fay's writing is hilarious. There are very hilarious moments in here. I could not get enough of it. And then the last one is a Grinch retelling, okay? This is How the Monster Stole Me on Christmas Eve by Jade Price. This one, I didn't give like that high of a rating, but it's still iconic to like talk about because I think it is just so hilarious. So yes, this is inspired by the Grinch, but the Grinch in here, as you can like tell by the cover, is more muscular and hotter. and he decides to like kidnap Cindy, okay, from her home and bring her to his mountain. And things happen, okay? This one was super funny, and I'm left wondering if there are more Grinch retellings, because I just think that's iconic, okay? Anyways, there you have it. Those were some monster paranormal romances that take place during Christmas time or the holiday season. Please let me know down below if you've read any of these books or if you plan to. And if you don't feel like commenting any of those things, you can leave me the Santa emoji in the comment section down below. Also, leave your holiday books that deal with monsters or paranormal creatures. I always want to read more, okay? Especially during this season, okay? Anyways, thank you all so much for watching. I will see y'all soon in my next one. Bye, y'all.